So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. All right, so let's begin with guys with the very first question, which says, following are the objectives of Gender Samvad that was organized by the Ministry of Rural Development except. So you have to identify which of the following is not one of the objectives of the Gender Samvad initiative. All right, and remember, it was organized by Ministry of Rural Development, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, and of course he is also the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Okay. And guys, this Gender Samvad is a joint initiative under DAY, NRLM, Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Rural Livelihood Mission, and IWWAGE, IWAGE. Okay, it is, guys, basically it is an initiative of a not-for-profit organization. We'll talk about this later. Now, this guys, Gender Samvad is for generating greater awareness on gender related interventions. जो gender related informations है, gender related interventions है, gender related topics है, gender related issues है, उनपे awareness generate करने के लिए this gender संवाद initiative or the campaign has been organized by the ministry. And these are some basic information about the gender संवाद, the basic aims and objectives. Number one, it will provide opportunities guys to understand the best practices of other states that they are following to improve the women agencies. Number two, it will help to understand gender interventions globally. Number three, the event provides opportunities to engage with expert on suggestions to handle implementation barriers. Jo bhi implementation barriers hote hain about the gender issues, usko remove karne ke liye, this will provide a greater opportunity. Also, it aims to promote the need to focus on the gender related issues. All right, so these are some basic objectives and aims of this campaign Gender Samvad. And talking about IWAGE, so remember, IWAGE stands for Initiative for What Works to Advance Women and Girls in the Economy. This is the full form of IWAGE. It is Initiative for What Works to Advance Women and Girls in the Economy is the full form. And remember, it is an initiative of LEAD, which is an action oriented research center. LEAD, what is LEAD? It is an action oriented research center of IFMR Society, which is guys a not-for-profit organization, and it is registered under the Societies Registration Act of 1860. And remember, IWAGE is supported by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. This is very important, you should remember this. IWAGE is supported by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Alright, so this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify which of the following is not one of the objectives. To promote the need to focus on gender issues, yes, this is one of the objectives. It helps to understand gender interventions globally. This is also one of the objectives. It will provide opportunity to engage with experts on suggestions to handle implementation barriers. This is also one of the objectives. Provides opportunities to understand the best practices of other states to improve women agencies. This is also one of the objectives, which means the correct answer should be option E, to provide information on need of nutritious food for girls and women. Aisa kuch nahi hai. जो जेंडर रिलेटेड इंटरवेंशन है, जेंडर रिलेटेड इश्यूज है, उस पर अवेयरनेस जनरेट करने के लिए दिस कैंपेन वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट. सो देयरफॉर ऑप्शन ई गाइस हियर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. अंडर आत्मनिर्भर भारत 3.0 मिशन कोविड सुरक्षा. सो इफ यू रिमेंबर, मिशन कोविड सुरक्षा वॉज अनाउंस्ड इन द आत्मनिर्भर भारत 3.0, एंड फॉर दैट 900 करोड़ वर अलॉटेड to provide the financial support to the pharma companies for boosting the production of COVID vaccine in our country. Okay, so it was announced by the Ministry of Science and Technology. What is the purpose of this move? So this was announced under Atmanirbhar Bharat 3.0, and as I told you, 900 crores were provided to accelerate the development and production of the indigenous COVID vaccine. It is guys being implemented by the Department of Biotechnology, which is under the Ministry of Science and Technology, of course. And who is the Minister for Science and Technology? It's Dr. Harshvardhan, we all know. And under the mission, the Department of Biotech is providing financial support as a grant to the pharmaceutical companies so that they can give a boost to the production of COVID vaccine in our country. And these are some target guys of vaccine production in our country. Current production, we are producing nearly 1 crore vaccine doses per month. By May-June 2021, the target is to double this production capacity. By July-August 2021, this will be increased by 6-7 times. And by September 2021, it is targeted that the vaccine production will be increased by 10 times. Okay, so nearly 10 crore monthly vaccine produced hogi by the September 2021. All right. And the financial support, guys, is providing by the Department of Biotechnology to three public sector companies. Number one, Bharat Biotech Limited, around 65 crore rupees. Halfkind Biopharma Corporation Limited, Mumbai, rupees 65 crore again. And Indian Immunologicals Limited, Hyderabad. Inko kitna funding provide karaya ja raha hai, iska koi data government ne nahi diya hai. Okay. So this was about this news, guys. And now let's come back to the question. What is the purpose of the move? So I hope now the purpose is clear. It is to accelerate the production of COVID vaccines by providing financial support to the COVID vaccines manufacturing companies. So option A here is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is, guys, a very important question. It is about a report. Consider the following statements regarding National Climate Vulnerability Assessment Report released in April 2021. And you have to identify which statements are not correct. Right? So you have to identify the incorrect statement regarding National Climate Vulnerability Assessment Report. So let's talk about this report. And question number 4, guys, is also based on this. So this report, guys, has been released by the Department of Science and Technology. And the full title of the report is what? Climate Vulnerability Assessment for Adaptation Planning in India Using a Common Framework. This is the full title, but you should remember only this: National Climate Vulnerability Assessment Report. And this report identifies the most vulnerable states and districts in India which are prone to the climate risk in our country. Hamare desh ke aise states, aise union territories, aise districts ko identify kiya gaya hai through this report, jo ki zyada risky hai in terms of climate change. Okay. And guys, इस report को बनाने में, this report has been jointly prepared by the Department of Science and Technology and Swiss Agency for Development and Cooperation. This is very important. You should remember this. This report has been jointly prepared by Department of Science and Technology and the Swiss Agency for Development and Cooperation. And it uses a common framework for both the states and union territories. States और union territories के लिए common framework use किया गया है. कोई different framework नहीं है दोनों के लिए. To make them comparable, thereby empowering their decision making capabilities at the policy and administrative levels. All right. And these are some key indicators which are used for the assessment, like percentage of population living BPL, income share from natural resources, the proportion of marginal and small land holdings, women's participation in the workforce, and density of healthcare workers. And the very important thing to remember that it is a part of the capacity building program of the National Action Plan on Climate Change. So National Action Plan ke andar 8 missions hai, uske andar 2 missions hai, uske andar ke jo capacity building programs hai, uska ye part hai. Okay. And which are these two missions? National Mission on Sustaining the Himalayan Ecosystem and National Mission on Strategic Knowledge for Climate Change. Okay. And these are, guys, some of the key findings of the report. So this report has put 8 states in the highly vulnerable states category: Jharkhand, Mizoram, Orissa, Chhattisgarh, Assam, Bihar, Arunachal Pradesh, and West Bengal. And if you notice, all these states are from the eastern side of our country. Pura ka pura kahan se hai? Eastern side se hai. Talking about lower middle vulnerable states, so these are Himachal Pradesh, Telangana, Sikkim, and Punjab. 4 states are there. And about the low vulnerable states, these are Uttarakhand, Haryana, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Nagaland, Goa, and Maharashtra. Alright, so these are the 3 categories of vulnerable states: highly vulnerable, lower middle vulnerable, and low vulnerable. Alright. And highly vulnerable districts ke baare mein agar baat karein, so among all these states, Assam, Bihar, and Jharkhand have over 60% districts in the category of highly vulnerable districts. And this report also says that the vulnerability scores in all the districts in India lies in a very small range, which means that all the districts and states are somewhat vulnerable with respect to the क्लाइमेट रिस्क इन आर कंट्री. ओके, मतलब जो हमारे देश के जितने भी डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स हैं और स्टेट्स हैं, वो कहीं ना कहीं क्लाइमेट रिस्क से जूझ रहे हैं आज भी. सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट, गाइस, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 and 4. हियर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इट इज रिलीज बाय द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. इट इज जॉइंटली सपोर्टेड बाय द स्विस एजेंसी फॉर डेवलपमेंट एंड कोऑपरेशन, अगेन एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. and the assessment uses a different framework for the states and UT. No, we have discussed this. The assessment uses a common framework for all the states and union territories, which means this statement is incorrect. So we have to identify the incorrect statement. Yeah. So option C, only three will be the correct answer. And question number four is what? According to National Climate Vulnerability Assessment Report released by the Department of Science and Technology, which is our correct regarding climate vulnerability. So the report has identified 8 states as highly vulnerable to climate change. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Assam, Bihar and Jharkhand have over 60% districts in the category of highly vulnerable districts. This is also correct. Vulnerability scores in all districts in India lies in a very small range. Yes, which means that all the states and all the districts in our country are prone to the climate risk. Highly vulnerable states are highly vulnerable states lie mostly in the southern part of the country. No, all the highly vulnerable states lie in the eastern part of the country, which means this statement is incorrect. So therefore, guys, option D will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Ministry of Commerce and Industry launched the Startup India Seed Fund Scheme. And if you remember, it was announced in the month of January 2020 with an overall outlay of 945 crores. We have discussed this before. Which is not correct about the fund distribution process. Fund distribution ke process ke baare mein incorrect statement batana hai. So let's talk about this. So now the scheme, the Startup India Seed Fund Scheme, has been launched by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And this scheme aims to provide financial assistance to the startups for proof of concept, prototype development, product trials, market entry, commercialization. Basically, from starting to end, jab tak ki wo product banana start karenge, from where they are starting to design their products to the commercialization of the products. Pure ke liye funding provide karaya jayega by the ministry through this scheme, Startup India Seed Funds. Duration will be 4 years, 2021 to 2025. Total outlay 945 crores. Estimated beneficiaries is 3600 startups to 300 incubators. And the nodal department, guys, will be the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, DPIIT. And remember, there is an online portal which has been created by DPIIT, will allow incubators to apply for funds under it. Ek online portal hai, wahan pe jaake incubators jo hai, wo funds apply karenge. And remember, startups cannot apply for the funds. Only the incubators can. An experts advisory committee has been created by the DPIIT to execute and monitor the Startup India Seed Fund Scheme, which means the final decision on release of funds will be taken by the experts advisory committee. All right. And what are the grants that will be provided? So the grants of up to rupees 5 crores shall be provided to the eligible incubators selected by expert advisory committee. These selected incubators will in turn provide grants to the startups. And they will provide grants of up to rupees 20 lakhs for proof of concept or prototype development and the trials of the products. While 50 lakh investment, 50 lakh fund will be provided by the incubators to the startups for market entry and the commercialization of their products. Okay. So 5 crore rupees ka total grant mil sakta hai eligible incubators ko. And then these eligible incubators will provide funding to the startups. 20 lakhs you can see at the initial stage, and after the product is ready, they will be provided with 50 lakh funding from the incubators for their commercialization of their product. Okay. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify incorrect statement about the fund distribution process. Incubators will apply for funds under the online portal created by DPIIT. This is absolutely correct. And then these incubators will provide funds to the startups. Grants shall be provided to the eligible incubators selected by the experts advisory committee. Correct. Incubators shall provide grants to startups. This is absolutely right. Startups will apply grants to the expert advisory committee. No, startups will not apply for the grants. They will be provided grants by the incubators. So this statement is incorrect. Option D should be the correct answer. Okay. And now, guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. आपको ये सेशन कैसा लगा कमेंट करके जरूर बताएं. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.